What's going on, YouTube? This is Barfy here, and you're listening and watching Barfy and the Bastard Brigade. Be sure to like, follow, subscribe, and smash that bell so you can get all the notifications. Be sure to share with your friends, and thanks for watching. Now on to the show.
Something seriously wrong with you, man?
I'm aware.
Oh, man. I need something to drink. You got anything to drink?
I need a beer.
Get this man a beer. Somebody get this guy a goddamn Happy Meal. I was trying to do sober January, but it didn't work. A dry January.
Dry January, yeah. Fuck that. That shit ain't happening. Here's the thing. I like to be happy.
I like to be happy.
Oh my god.
I mean, you gotta. I haven't seen in a while, so I guess you should start off with annoying the shit out of you.
I don't know. I'm not gonna lie, I kinda like it.
What is going on, everybody? God. What is going on? How are we doing?
That's how are ridiculous. We doing, man? Doing all right.
Look who's here. Look, we're back. We're back.
Yeah, hey.
It's only been a month.
Yeah, it hasn't been that long, has it?
No, it hasn't been a month yet.
It's been a, not it's been a few while. Weeks.
I mean, so I guess I got to ask.
Yeah.
You been busy?
No.
No, not at all.
Not even in the slightest bit.
No, not at all.
I haven't done shit.
You haven't done shit?
No.
Really?
No, I really haven't done anything.
Damn.
Sitting around in my fucking house.
Oh, no.
You know, I don't know how you do it, man.
What?
Sit around my house? Bored out of my mind. Like, bored to tears.
You know what I do?
Watch TV.
I do podcasts. I make videos. I learn a craft.
Shut the fuck up. Learn a craft. What kind of craft are you learning? Yeah, craft beer. Yeah. No, it's I got COVID and I was extremely bored.
Have you noticed that like there's so many people, I don't know anybody, maybe one person who's not vaccinated that actually got COVID.
Like, I know plenty of people that are unvaccinated that got it. But I don't know that many people that are unvaccinated either. So
like half of my company completely just got COVID in one week. In 1 week's time, everybody in my district got COVID.
Yeah.
Except for me. I mean, I was...
Well, you're just special.
I literally crossed paths with you.
Uh-huh.
And about seven different people from my job. Not a sniffle.
Well, I mean, let's be honest here, too. I'm sure it's contagious, right? Obviously, it's contagious because you get it from somebody. But it's not as contagious, like, I think, as they say. Like, I don't think it's that easy to get it. Put it this way, I had it, and no one else in my house had it. Like, including my wife. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, obviously, I was having...
Oh, good for you!
I was not having a stellar week that week, obviously.
Get yourself COVID, not going to have yourself a good time.
I was having myself a bad time. But no, I mean, like, nobody got it, right? So that doesn't make any sense at all, right?
How the kids didn't get it, the baby didn't get it. You did give it to your neighbor, though.
I don't know for sure that I gave it to them, but maybe.
They had it after seeing you.
Yeah.
But I saw you and I hugged you and I was around you for about a good hour.
True. Yeah. Well, yeah, that's true. Yeah, we did see each other. I'm a little surprised that you didn't get it from me, but
I don't think
it's that contagious, like really.
At this point,
yeah.
I feel that I'm immune.
You're a superhuman.
I'm a superhuman.
I mean, that's makes sense. I think that's the only logical thing to think.
Think about it. When the Alpha variant first came out, I was in Las Vegas, and when they shut down Las Vegas.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
And not a sniffle. I was in a wedding in Florida, and where Florida doesn't give a fuck about anything, not a sniffle.
It's true.
I was at Monahan's wedding, and most of the people got it. And the boobage bastard was with me.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't get it. And then at work, everyone's, you know, falling left and right on it. Nothing. I'm covering everyone else because everyone else has got a fucking cough.
Well, maybe you should try to get it.
I'm, you know, at this point, I'm going to start licking doorknobs and toilet bowls and shit.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I mean, but, no, it's a serious thing. People have died. I know. I mean,
I know,
but at the same time, I'm just laughing because my buddy Chris vaccinated, you know, everyone. Whether you're crazy. Vaccinated or not, you
still going to get it.
Still get it.
Yep.
And you can still spread it.
Yep.
Yet why are we fighting about it?
I have no idea.
Like literally, we sometimes doing this for something that you don't agree with is better for all of us.
I said to my unvaccinated friend that didn't get it, but his wife did. I was like, well, at least I don't have to get the booster now. He was like, oh, what are you, a conspiracy theorist now? Now you don't want
to. They didn't do shit. All right,
dude. I'm like, I didn't really want to get it anyway. You know what I mean? Like,
that's what happens when you have a nagging wife.
Yes. I mean, I did it. You know, I got the first two because, you know, whatever. But at this point, I'm like, meh, whatever.
You got the first two.
Well, you know, and even my wife is not, she's not as crazy as she was at the beginning. You know what I mean?
So, well, yeah, now that she was literally in contact with someone for a fucking 2 weeks.
Right. So,
and the CDC even said it's okay to, you know, go back to work after 5 days because you're not contagious.
Yeah, like, exactly.
Okay. Like,
well, the other thing too is like, I probably had symptoms like, you know, I saw you, what was that? Christmas Eve. I had symptoms like probably like 2 or 3 days before that. By the time I even tested, it had already basically been 5 days, right? Like, so at that point, I probably wasn't even contagious anymore. Had it, obviously, but probably wasn't contagious anymore. And then technically after you test, you're supposed to like, quarantine for a certain amount of period. I'm like, that's fucking dumb. Right. Cause I'm like, I was most contagious in the beginning when I didn't even know I had it. Like, why does that make any sense at all?
Right. This Omicron, this, you know, Omnibot. GoBot of a virus, you know, it takes 3 days instead of 4 days to incubate and become, you know, part of your body and all that fun shit. But I don't know. Like I said, I literally worked with a bunch of people who got it. I did not get it, fortunately, but still at the same time, you know.
Yeah. It wasn't that bad. My sinuses were like, oh God, like the worst fucking sinus congestion I've ever had in my entire life. And of course I lost my taste.
Did you get your taste back?
I got
back
it back.
Yet?
Oh yeah, I wouldn't be drinking. I probably would still
do
drink.
Do you still like Metallica?
I fucking hate you so
clearly
much.
Clearly he doesn't have his taste back.
I fucking hate you.
Oh hell no!
You're an asshole. It's funny though. I'll give you that. I mean, I'll give you that.
You gotta be funny.
You can't be mad if it's funny.
I'm not even mad about
it. Yeah. I did get my taste buds back, but I was really afraid, honestly. It was like, fuck, dude, I've read about people and heard about people that like go 6 months, you know, and don't get their taste buds back. Holy shit. That is some next level depressing shit right there. Not being able to taste food. Seriously.
You could have done the one chip challenge.
Yeah, you're right. I missed my opportunity to do it.
You missed your opportunity to do the one chip challenge.
Well, granted, I did eat some spicy shit and I couldn't taste it, but it still burned my throat. You know what I mean? Like,
I mean, yeah,
it was weird.
But was your tongue on fire?
No, not really.
Like, my throat's on fire. Okay.
Yeah.
You know, drink some vodka and you're done with it. But, you know,
it was very odd, right? Like, I don't even know how to describe it. I've never lost my taste buds like that. I mean, like, it was just,
I don't know.
Like, I couldn't smell anything either.
I mean, have you ever had taste? I mean, I've seen some of the women you've dated.
Yo, it's your cousin, man.
I mean, I wasn't even talking about your wife. I said I've seen some of the women you've dated.
What are you doing?
God damn it,
bro.
Why do I let you plug in?
I don't know, because you enjoy it. That's why. You turned me down, though.
I did not turn you down.
No, it just was very low.
Or you turned the volume up on your Bluetooth device.
I could do that.
So
you don't want me to do that, though.
No. Oh, no, I don't.
No.
But get it all. He hasn't touched the sound machine since.
It's been
Christmas.
Weeks. You know, it's been so long.
It's a very Barfy Christmas. You know. So New Year's was a bust for you, right?
It was complete bust, yeah. I just sat in my house. I think I got some of my taste buds back by then because I did drink on New Year's, but yeah, it was just us. We just had around. Bought some cheap ass fireworks from Walmart. Some boring, for the most boring fucking fireworks you could buy.
Just snakes and sparks.
Yeah, it was just, no, I mean, it was better than that, but it was like, everything was like, you know, just.
Like little. just little streamers and just shit. Like, fountains. It was all fountains.
I was like, this is so fucking gay. Oh my God.
I had to work. I literally, it was Friday. I remember it was New Year's Eve. And I'm like, all right, a few hours, going to be out. And then my boss calls me at 2:00 and he goes, I need you in this store by 2:30. I'm like, first off, it's a 35-40 minute drive to get there.
Right.
If I left right now. And I'm like, what the fuck?
That's ridiculous.
I put a hole through a wall in typical Barfy fashion when I get mad. I scared this one little girl. That one of my employees, she literally not
so little, you're a midget.
No, well, we're sitting down. I mean, she. Never mind. I can't because in case any of my staff ever sees this, I can't. I don't want to rip them too bad.
Yeah, for sure.
I like sat there. I took my scanner. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm slamming it, screaming, punched a hole in the wall. I'm like, fuck this. Y'all run this fucking place. I'm done with this shit. And then it was like,
that's one of those people that quits on a Friday and comes back on Monday.
No, I had to work Friday night and I had to be back Saturday and to be back Sunday. And I'm like, hey, there's nobody to work the store on Monday, but Monday's my day off. And my boss is like, oh, well, there's temp workers. They'll do it. I'm like, what kind of fucking company just throws temp workers into a building with high priced volume? Like, there's fucking Beats headphones on the walls.
Yeah.
You're a temp worker making fucking $15 an hour and you see nice Beats headphones and no one there to watch you.
Yeah.
Fuck it. I am five finger discounting that thing myself.
I saw like something. It was, on Facebook or something like that. And it was like, somebody posted like, I love going to Walmart. It's so much fun. And then Walmart was like, oh, what's your favorite thing to do at Walmart? And the person was like, steal.
Well, I mean, they're stepping up their game with their new self-checkout employees.
They are, because I've gotten hit with it a couple times. Like, it was like, oh, you misscan. I'm like, I fucking scanned it. Okay.
I fucking scanned it.
Is that what you're talking about? Where like it's looking down at you. And trying to figure out if you scanned it.
If you double scanned something. Right.
Or if you don't scan it. Yeah.
That's why you gotta hold two things together and put it in a 90 degree, like a...
Oh my God. I stole so much shit from Walmart before
fuck
that.
Just walk through the front fucking door. Yeah, who's going to stop you? The old fucking broad in the front? Yeah, it scares me, son. I need to see your... Yeah. Fuck you, Grandma. It's... Grow a beard. Because beards are good. And scruff.
And scruff. I mean... Yeah, I mean, they're never going to chase you down, and realistically, what are they going to do?
Yeah, chase you down in a fucking rascal?
No, I don't really want to steal stuff that badly, but I mean, you know, swiping a couple things, you know.
Right. There's times where, like, I'll be like...
Fuck Walmart.
I'll be looking at something. Yeah, fuck you, Sam Walton. I hope someone digs up your grade and fucking fucks your skull.
I thought you were going to say something. I was like, he's dead, right?
Yeah, Sam Walton's dead. The rest of that family just divides his money up every time he comes in. Like, oh, here's our royalty check. Yep, here's another $500 million to me. Here you go, Uncle Jeff. Here's another $500 million to you. Oh, there's that tax incentive check that we get from underpaying our employees. There you go. Cousin Jimmy, you needed that new Bentley, right? Yeah, there you go. There you go. Thanks there, Sam. Fucking hate. I hate Walmart with a passion.
Mm-hmm.
Hate him with a passion.
I know, me too.
But did you get anything good for Christmas at least? Any new toys? Nothing?
No. I mean, I got some stuff. I got some pizza making stuff. Lisa got me some pizza making stuff.
Did you get some high quality handmade children's presents? No? Me neither. You know what I got for Christmas for my kid?
What?
A fucking Reese's, like a Reese's cup. Not like a big thing. No, a Reese's cup. Yeah, zoom in on that there, camera. A Reese's cup. That's it. A Reese's cup from my child. I finally got socks. Very happy about that. I got socks and underwear.
Oh.
About fucking time. That's
exciting.
And pots and pans.
Yeah, I knew you were getting pots and pans.
We all knew I was getting pots and pans. Thanks, Mom.
No, I mean, I did get some stuff. My sister-in-law got me beer, which was awesome. I drank it all already.
the beer. It's gone.
It was gone. It was gone immediately. I drank part of it while it was still there. She was like, you gotta, yeah, you were there. You were there. She was like, well, I gotta give you your present now. And I'm like, really? She's like, yeah. And it was wrapped, you know, like it was like four packs, you know, beer, whatever. It was wrapped and in her fridge, like in, so it was already cold. Then I like, oh, she's like, okay, here you go. And like set it up there. I'm like, it's cold. It's beer. It's like,
cool. Opens it up. It's just a wheel of cheese.
Yeah.
It's a Wisconsin log with all the fucking nuts and shit on it. I know. Gross.
But no, I mean, I guess I got a couple good things, but nothing terribly exciting.
Yeah.
That's typical.
I bought myself a Christmas present.
Nice. What'd you get?
Which is this little.
Oh, the camera.
This little guy right there. Hey, little guy. Hey there, little guy.
It's a nice camera.
And I got this beautiful microphone here.
Nice.
A new microphone. I'm testing it out today.
Testies.
Testies, testies. One, two, testies. And I don't know. I'm trying to figure out if I like it or not. I don't know if it feels the boom in my voice or, I mean, we did a test run. I sent you a test run.
It sounds a lot different. I'll put it that way.
Yeah.
So like this one is a lot more clear,
right?
Like crisp, you know, crisp. And that one's definitely
got some mid to it.
Yeah. A lot of,
yeah, mid. It's got, it does. And I hate mid. That's,
but you
the
don't
hard.
Have to be that close to it, which is kind of nice.
I could sit back here.
Yeah. And I can still hear you. So
yeah. The problem is that when I'm, the further I get back, you hear more room noise.
Well, you have a tendency to yell a lot, you know.
The fuck you mean I yell a lot?
So it's probably good that you sit back a little bit.
I don't fucking yell. Ever.
I'm sorry. I must have you confused with someone else. I was thinking of someone else.
It was all you. I've seen your Christmas videos.
I, man.
I've seen your family videos.
You don't know me.
You don't know me.
You don't fucking know me.
All they said was, did that cider come with a matching vagina?
So Christmas Eve, we didn't even talk about this. So Christmas Eve, you showed up at my sister-in-law's, you know, late, right before we were leaving. And, and so I'm like, all right, well, it's about time to go. I don't know. We stuck around for a while longer than we wanted to. It was probably like 11:30 or something like that. We're like, all right, it's time to get the fuck out of here. So we go get out to the car. And load up the car. Everything's in there. Everybody gets in the car. I sit down. You know, it's a push start. You know, go to hit the thing. Nothing.
I was there.
And I'm not telling you the story, asshole.
Oh. So you're trying to tell me, like, oh, after you left,
No. Yeah, and I'm like, nothing. And I'm like, fuck. So I'm like, all right, well, somebody's got to have jumper cables, right? Nope. Nobody had jumper cables. I had to call AAA. It was a nightmare.
Oh, I remember. Yeah. I was trying to get you
cables. But I mean, you know, it's okay. Cause the AAA came, the guy, you know, hooked up his box and, you know, it wasn't that big of a deal, but I mean, it still ended up, you know, taking over. Luckily we were there and everybody just went back inside the house. You know what I mean? So we weren't just sitting in the car somewhere. I mean, it could have been a lot worse, but like, what's the fucking likelihood of my car? Cause I mean, my battery has died before. Right. But it's been months. Right. And of course the battery dies on Christmas fucking Eve. Well, you know what I mean? Like, of course that's when the battery.
It's a Christmas miracle.
It couldn't have been like the day before Christmas Day. I mean, it could have been so many other days, but nope. Christmas Eve, the battery's like, I'm just not going to work today.
All right. I'm going to head out. All right, I'm going to head out.
The fuck, man, you have one job, you know, like.
Turn over. That's all you gotta do is just enough spark, just enough.
Bang. Whatever. I'm just
to crank the engine over.
I'm just used to stupid shit like that. You know, like.
I know your wife was like, "Jesus, you're like,
whatever." I was also pretty hammered at that point, so
you were rather vishnigged.
I was not as hammered as my brother-in-law. Holy shit, he was a fucking puddle, man.
What a puddle! This man was so Asian eye, man.
Oh my God, I don't think I've ever seen him that drunk.
He was Jimmy Wong that night.
He was
saying all the Wong things.
He was just, dude. Oh, it was really funny.
I was waiting for him to be like,
he was close, man. He just was a mess. I'm like, Jimmy, you got jumper cables, right? No. How the man knows. He has to have jumper cables.
He's like, a Snap-on salesman.
Yeah,
you're a Snap-on salesman. How do you not have? Where do you get those wonderful toys?
Right,
real? Where? What the fuck, man?
Yeah, he had one of those jump boxes, but of course it wasn't charged.
It was not charged.
Yeah, so which, you know, there's, if you don't keep it charged, it's pretty much useless at that point. It's just a big fucking brick. But anyway.
House. It's a brick. House.
But yeah, that about summed up my fucking Christmas break, because that was exactly how all of it went.
So did you miss any work since you work remote, or did you work?
No. Which is the most bullshit thing about it is like, my boss is like, oh man, that sucks. Can you give me that report later on today? Fuck.
My boss literally called me and he's like, all right, so I need you to work in this store, this site, then go to this site. And then, I need you to do the reports for these sites too. I'm like, get the fuck out of here. It takes me 4 hours. That's half my work day right there. My schedule, 10-hour shifts or whatever bullshit they want to try to throw on me, would be just to do reports. And in the middle of doing those reports, hey, you got a call. Hey, we got a call. Hey, you got a call.
Oh my God.
And
need an analytics guy.
I need a secretary. I mean,
like, you're doing reports. Like, you shouldn't be doing reports. You should be fucking running the store.
They're all trackers. It's all spreadsheets to justify someone else's fucking job.
Like, doesn't even make any sense.
Like, that, literally, I start saying that. I'm like, in my Slacks or emails, I'm like, hey, I know you need this report to justify that you actually get that you actually do work in this company, but I'm not doing it.
What do you have in your Slacks?
Salami.
This dog was paying special attention to you tonight. I didn't know that was why.
He was real friendly.
Oh my God. What do you got in your pockets, man? Pork chops?
So we lost the great one right on New Year's Eve.
Betty White. Yeah.
And which sad. Is funny is
it made me sad.
I was actually like,
I usually don't care about celebrities, but I don't know. I always thought she was cool as shit, right?
It was, yeah, she was a badass broad, yeah. Man. And of course, that was literally, I found out literally as I'm pulling into the site after I'm screaming on the phone, fuck this place, fuck this job, fuck you, fuck, blah, blah. And then I get, oh, Betty White just died. I'm like, what? I'm punching my steering wheel.
Okay, yeah. I wasn't that upset.
Well, no, it was like the combined bullshit of my day, and then Betty White died. I was actually going to have like a Betty White party of just,
oh my God,
like when she had her 100th birthday celebration and shit. I was all geared up for it.
Oh my
and
God.
And then no, she's dead. But hold on 1 second.
What is this?
I did.
Oh my God.
I did get this in the mail, and I whoever you are, thank you. It is called Golden Gilfs. Like, look at this. Look. You got Betty White, B. Arthur, Estelle Getty, and I can never remember Blanche's name.
Oh, yeah.
Can never remember that broad's name. But, you know, and unfortunately, I can't. Actually, I can show you this one. I can show you this one. This is the only clean thing. It says, Happy Gangbang Day.
Oh my God!
I might need to peruse.
You
need
this
to look at
bit.
This.
Yeah.
I want to see your reaction. I'm actually going to zoom in on your reaction.
To zoom in on my God! Wait, which one's this one, Joe? I forget.
I think that's Blanche. That's the southern one.
I thought
one.
Blanche was the tall one. No. Oh my God! Holy shit! Oh. Oh, it has a story.
Yes, it's a story about Gangbang Day. I'm not going to read it right now. After I color it in, maybe. I got to color it in. It's going to take me some time.
Oh, my God. I really want to read this.
And
wow. Yeah, you need to color it in.
I'm never going to have
to. You want one of my kids to color it in for you?
No, absolutely fucking not.
I'm just kidding.
Yes, yes. You know what?
I'm
joking.
We want one of the boys to color it in.
Any of your kids, you know, feeling a little light on the toes there? You think you like boys now?
Yeah.
Here's a picture of Estelle Getty in a garter belt. Yeah, let that marinate.
Oh, my God, this is like ridiculous.
Let that marinate.
There's actually not that much nudity in here.
Oh, not?
No, no. Okay. No, it's, well, I mean, there's, you know, there's some.
I mean, literally, there's a picture of someone getting Eiffel Towered.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm getting there. Yeah. I'm getting there. Oh, okay. Yeah, towards the back. I mean, you know.
That's what she said, too. Was,
had to work their way up to it, you know? Holy Jesus. Yeah, it's a gangbang. Whoa, look at that bush. Holy shit.
I haven't seen bush like that since the World Trade Centers went down.
Oh. Oh, my Lord.
So, as you're perusing that.
I'm almost done.
So, this happened in November, but I feel it just way it ends to sum up the year of 2021.
Hi, and this is my impression of when Shakira goes to wash her hands, but the water's too hot.
So I found the news here that wild boars stole Shakira's purse in Barcelona.
That's just weird. I don't even understand. Like, how does a boar steal your purse?
Wild boars don't give a fuck.
Well, I mean, obviously.
Where's that guy on TikTok that talks about animals with his little microphone? Wild boars do not give a fuck. And they don't care if you're internationally renowned superstar Shakira. They will steal your purse. When Shakira made an innocent mistake of hanging out in a Barcelona park with her son, Milan Mubarak. Milan Mubarak.
Mubarak. Jesus Christ.
Singer says, it was crazy, he told Glamour UK. I got my son a little ice cream, and we sat on one of those park benches where we just minding our own business. And then wild boars came from the back. They always come from the back.
Terrible accent.
She's like a Brazilian or something like that.
I think so. I
South America. She's some form of Latin. That sounds like a goat. Whatever.
Oh my Lord.
Yeah. Minor business. And then two huge wild boars came from the back and ambushed us and took my purse. I was like, oh my God. Oh my God. And screaming. Oh my God. Nobody gives a shit. But, you know, it had her phone, her car keys, everything. And, people were just watching. Like, they're like, fuck you want us to do about it?
I mean, that's pretty funny though.
That's just stupid.
And, you know,
oh man.
So watch out for wild boars there, Shakira. That sucks to be you. Like, okay.
Yeah. I don't even have words for that. It's just weird. You know what I mean? Like, right. like first of all, like,
watch her for surroundings, lady. Like, well, what the fuck?
No, not even that. I just mean like, where was she that there was fucking wild boar?
In Barcelona.
I just mean like
in a park in Barcelona.
I know, but are they're just wandering around in fucking Spain? Like, I don't get
it. I mean, in America, we just kill everything, but
look, I've spent like multiple weeks in Maine, right? Multiple weeks and New Hampshire and, you know, all up in that area. And all I want to see is a fucking moose.
For real.
And there are signs that say moose crossing. I've never seen a fucking moose.
Have you ever seen a moose knuckle?
I hate you so much. I really do. I don't even have any. I lost my complete train of thought. No, but you know what I mean? Like
those fuckers are fast too. And they can like swim to the bottom of the river they could literally just stand on the bottom of the river bed and like come out of the water like fucking hippos and shit.
What?
Yeah. Hippos are, I mean, the hippos.
I don't even know hippos, but.
Moose are fucking crazy, man.
Oh, shit. I didn't know.
Yeah, they can run like 30 miles an hour.
I find it funny because I, you know, as many times I've been there, I'm like, I'll never see one. And then they have those like moose tours, you know, it's like, oh yeah, we're going to, you know, well, 98%, you know, chance that you'll see a moose. I'm like, yeah, bullshit.
Oh, I went to see a moose and all I saw was a damn flying squirrel. What did you do, Rocky?
I'm like, they've got a fucking like cardboard cutout. So they're like, oh, look, there's one over there. They're like, we go out at night because you can see them better. Yeah, okay.
Oh, there's a horns over there.
Oh, don't you see it? Oh, no, he's sleeping.
Oh, you scared it. Oh, you scared it away with your big flashlight and your big diesel engine, you fucking cack.
Oh, God. But like, you do see, I've seen, you know, wildlife and I've obviously deer, you fucking see deer everywhere, but I've seen bears. I mean, I've seen, you know, bears out in the wild, but like a wild boar is like,
yeah,
I mean, I get it. It's not, you know, the US, but It's beyond me.
Going back to moose.
Yeah.
Because boar is boar, and I'm kind of bored with it. Thank you very much. Try the veal. When moose, like, were coming into mating season, right before mating season, they have this fur on their antlers. And it'll when it sheds off of them, it looks like they just gutted a deer. Like, it just looks like carcass coming off in blood. But it's not. It's just felt on their horns, on their antlers and shit. Moose are cool.
Oh, sorry.
What the fuck?
That was a that was an ad. I was going to pull something up, but a fucking ad came up first, of course.
God damn it. Way to go.
It would have been funnier without the ad. I apologize.
Where's the rest of this moose? Arthur, I think it's time we got to know one another.
I do too. That's why I had you come over today. This is a tough room. I don't have to tell you that. You must have hated this moose.
Why don't you forget the moose?
That was my big thing.
All right, enough monkeying around. Enough monkeying around about the moose.
Why don't you forget the moose?
Forget the moose. We're not going to monkey around about the moose anymore. We're going to go on to monkeys.
Oh my god!
So,
show about animals.
I saw this article, and I thought this is fucking amazing. And it says a troop of monkeys has killed up to 250 dogs in revenge attacks, including throwing them off tall buildings, reports say in India.
Monkeys are killing dogs.
Yes, monkeys are grabbing dogs and yeeting them off buildings and shit. Like, for real, it just, they call it revenge attacks because a dog killed a baby monkey.
Surprise, motherfucker.
And the dog killed a baby monkey. So these I guess you want to call it guerrilla warfare. The monkeys attacked the dogs. Like, literally, it's raining dogs in India in Bangalore.
It's the monkeys on the roofs. I don't even understand. You have the weirdest shit. I don't even understand how the fuck that's even possible.
I don't mean monkeys can pick up a dog. I mean they do have they are strong.
Yeah, but yes, I get that. I just mean physically, like, how is that, like, what, why, and you know,
because
they're calling them revenge attacks.
A dog killed a baby monkey.
I know, but it's not like the monkeys are like, oh shit. You know?
I don't know. We tried to kill each other over a fucking neo throat. So why not? If we can go, yes, if a monkey, we're
way more intelligent beings.
We sure about that?
Well, you know,
we kind of did the same thing that these animals did. So obviously we ain't that much. We haven't evolved that much.
We've evolved enough.
Clearly. But.
What are you playing with over there?
Mic stand. Yeah. Little mini mic stand. But so yeah, they're just fucking like chucking puppies out the door. Like, you know. Sorry, Fido. Oh man. But you know, enough about puppies getting thrown out. That gives me a long face.
Sorry.
Oh, no.
You know, I'm over here pressing buttons because, yeah.
But speaking of people going crazy over, you know, cops accidentally killing people or intentionally, whatever you want to think of that, whatever. A police department in New Hampshire has decided to do something about this.
About what?
About, you know, being more with, you know,
like the community.
Yes.
Focused. Okay.
Gotcha. The community focus. Yeah. Manchester police introduced a comfort pony as the newest member of the New Hampshire Police Department.
Comfort pony.
Yes. Like a little Sebastian. It's a Shetland pony.
I mean, it sounds adorable.
It's fucking adorable.
I'm not going to lie.
I mean, but don't get me wrong. They ain't horsing around about crime.
Stop it. Stop. Stop the show right the fuck now. If you make one more bad joke, I'm going to get up and leave. I can't do this right now. Jesus Christ. I just, you know what you do? You sit here and you wait for the, you're like, all right, I've got these articles that I'm going to read. And here's the stupid fucking joke I'm going to make. Just to fucking get a chuckle out of Dan. So fucking funny over there. I hate you. Good. I hope you die. I'm just kidding. Don't die.
So Dan.
Asshole. Stop it. No.
Why the long face?
God.
Oh, shit. Oh, that was great. A 20-year-old Shetland pony named Eddie has a friendly demeanor and his easygoing attitude.
Oh, my God.
And is all about meeting and greeting people, according to the police department. He is perfect for this. He loves attention, he loves being around people, and he just wants to eat and snuggle.
Oh.
Perfect. Please put that on his Grindr profile.
I love to eat and snuggle.
My name is Officer Buttercup. I love to eat and snuggle. Me! As long as you wash my hair with horse and mane.
Oh, my God. Stop it.
Actually, horse and mane is a shampoo that's meant for horses and your own hair.
Is it really?
Yes. I'm not horse around right, about that
all
one.
All right, stop it. okay. All right. Wait, let's go back to the story itself. What does that mean, a fucking comfort pony? Why does a police department need a comfort pony?
I guess they're running out of service dogs.
Like...
People,
what are they going to do? Like, go knock on the people's doors? Like,
you just see him walk up.
you just sit here and read articles and set them up for bad jokes.
You think you handled that one all by yourself there?
No, I just like to make you poop your pants a little bit every time I play that one. I set myself up and knew that was coming.
I'm watching you giving the Petra wave off the...
Anyway, no, where do they go from house to house? Yeah, I know. From house to house and like, you know, oh, here, come pet the fucking pony. Like, what? Come all for like, you know, police, like, I don't know,
sorry,
community policing and that stuff. I'm all for that. It makes sense. But why the fuck do you need to?
Sorry, little Timmy. Your mom passed away in the shower. In the
shower.
She was in the bathtub with a toaster. But, if you need to talk to anybody, here's Officer Buttercup. He will.
Officer Buttercup.
Just hop on his back, give him some carrots, and he'll butter. Take away all. He will listen to all your problems.
Buttered stuff.
Butternuts.
Butter. I didn't know the horse was diabetic.
What did you feed him? Wow, you got some Lucky Charms, some corn pop. This horse is a diabetic. Say his name. Buttered stuff. Buttercup. Butternut.
Oh, my God.
But, yeah, I mean. So that's light and hearted.
I mean, that's cute.
And that's from December 28th, this article I found.
Wow.
So this is recent shit I've been looking for.
Manchester in New Hampshire? There's a Manchester in New
Manchester,
Hampshire.
Manchester, New Hampshire.
Interesting.
Yep.
Fucking weird up there.
I mean, we're running out of money for shit, so let's buy a fucking pony. I mean, you know, whatever.
Dude, how much crime is there in New Hampshire? In Manchester, New Hampshire? There's like 7 people that live in New Hampshire. You know what I mean? Like,
I think there's more than that, but
17.
Yeah. Bob Dole, who also died.
Really?
Bob Dole just died not too long ago.
Well, he doesn't live there anymore.
I mean, his arm still does though. Or that was in Iwo Jima. I forget where he lost his arm.
Oh my God.
Bob Dole. Bob Dole passed away. You're not a cat person, are you?
No.
Good.
Hate cats.
So, your cat could burn down your house, it says.
This is literally all about animals.
Yeah, it's all about animals because it's the only good news that's going on here. Your cat could burn your house down, a Korean officials warned after 107 fires were sparked by felines.
Well, I'm not even in the least bit surprised by that.
I mean, they're just not pussyfooting around with this shit anymore.
I'm just going to glance right over that one. If I, here's the thing with your jokes,
this in the bud.
If you, damn it. So I was going to say, if I laugh at your jokes, I encourage you and you make more. No, it's not that surprising, honestly, when you think about it, right? Because, you know, you got a candle, that motherfucker just, you know, cats like to knock everything off of everything, right?
Cats are assholes.
Yeah, they're assholes. So like, you know, I can imagine how it would start a fire very easily. Dogs do it too. But just because they're idiots and they smack it with their tail or something, you know.
Right, dogs will say.
But dogs won't get up on top of something and knock it down, typically.
Right, they'll just, I'm so happy to see you. I'm so happy to see you. You're here to be my best friend.
He's a cat. Flushing the toilet, he's a cat.
He's a cat. He's setting your house on fire.
Oh my God.
I was going to do President of the United States of America, but I felt that would be a little bit better.
Fuck you, kitty.
You're going to spend the night outside.
Yeah, I love that song, too. I hate cats, man.
Cats or like women.
Yeah.
It's like, meow, pet me, meow, feed me, meow, leave me alone. Fuck your shit.
Yep.
Yeah.
100%.
Fuck. I'm very allergic to cats, so if you want to kill me, just put a cat in my face.
I'm allergic to, yeah.
And... you know, they always said pussy was going to kill you.
Is that what they said?
That's what they say. I read it in an article somewhere. My therapist said it to me, I think, actually. Right. He's like, you know, Joe, that pussy's going to kill you someday. You know, here, I thought you meant women.
That is probably what you would be your demise.
I mean, if I'm going out, I mean, hopefully I'm going out that way.
Not by fucking mittens. I didn't mean it that way.
Yeah, not by mittens, by fucking, you know.
Oh, my God.
Hairless cats are adorable.
What? No, they're not.
Yes, I want to get a Harold's cat named Scrotum.
Yeah, that's what they look like for sure.
Right, Lamar Scrotum is going to be his name.
Lamar Scrotum.
And I feel that would be most be excellent.
Black hairless cat. Lamar Scrotum. What are you going? Come on, Scrotes. What are you doing?
Here, Scrotum. Here.
Oh, dude. Something wrong with you, seriously.
I haven't seen you in 3 weeks.
I know.
I got lonely.
I got lonely.
I got lonely. All I did was work.
It's hard to make jokes to yourself.
It really is. Poor therapist Ashley just had to deal with my shit.
Oh, my God.
She's just probably like, God, this guy really needs his friends. He really needs a friend.
He really needs to be medicated.
All that, too.
Oh, my God. Do you have any more cat stories?
No, I don't have any more cat stories.
This has been an all-animal story, all-animal...
It really has.
Show. I mean, that's okay. There's nothing wrong with that.
Well, it's just like, I was trying to find some, like, lighthearted shit. And, Shakira, it. I mean... Yeah,
it's just funny.
I mean, you know.
Great song.
It's a great song. We're going to
You know what I love
cats.
About this song, too, is I feel the same way that they feel about cats.
Yeah.
Cats. Get the fuck outside.
For real.
Meow, 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 meow,
meow. Yeah, we don't own the rights to this music, for sure.
No, we don't own the rights at all. Of it. You know.
But a great song, man. That's a good one. You can talk over it.
Yeah, it's going to be a nice little jingle to get out.
That's been fun.
It has been fun.
We'll have to do it again sometime.
Yeah.
Next week?
Maybe next week.
That sounds good. We should do it next week.
You should definitely do it. Don't be catnapping on me, though.
Oh.
I'm supposed to be footing around jokes here right now.
I've been busier than a cat.
Nah. Everybody knows cats aren't busy, mate. Right?
No, I've been busier than a cat burying shit on concrete.
Chitty, won't you come inside?
Chitty, have a foot in a wall and touch it. Chitty, have a foot in a wall and touch it. Chitty, have a foot in a wall and touch it. Chitty, have a foot in a wall.
This song is such
a dumb song, but you know.
So for the younger generation out there who don't understand grunge music, this is on the tail end of the grunge.
Meow meow.
When shit was just weird.
Where it was just fucking weird.
Yeah, weird, like beyond weird.
Yeah, it was fucking.
But
I love it. Oh. Full-heartedly. And these guys were awesome live. They didn't have big stage show lights flashing.
That's why I love 12-Foot Ninja, because some of their songs are serious, but I love the weird shit. You know, like the just, I don't know, like, don't take yourself too seriously. You know what I mean? I love it.
night.
I know you love these guys.
They were amazing live. Like, probably one of the best shows that wasn't, like, a big show. It wasn't...
Yeah.
It wasn't light sound, a big theatrical. No, it was just two, three old guys. I mean...
Yeah.
And, they were just... They rocked out, and they played all the good songs.
Nice.
Even their new shit that, like, no one had any fucking clue what it was. It was like... Oh shit, they still have not changed one fucking bit.
Really?
And like,
I'll have to see them if they come around.
They probably never will come around again.
You're probably right.
They're like, I was like, this is our first time on tour in 20 years. I'm like,
really?
Yeah. Like, Spin Magazine didn't even put us in the top 200 best grunge bands of all time. We would have gladly accepted 200. I'm like,
that's a shame, actually. Ah, they're cool.
I wanna touch you. Touch you.
But so that'll do it for today, folks. Check us out, anchor.fm/BATBB. You can get all your information there. I'm trying to find our ending credits. Kitty, 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 touch it. See you guys later.
Touch it.
Touch it. Kitty, I'm a fool and I want to touch it.